Does a Dean Ball wake up and see headlines like this with everyone pulling their hair out? We're putting in buy and sell orders based on this story and roll your eyes? Do you have a much longer view than this particular news flow that might be missing the point?
No, I think it's a pretty substantial story, actually. So Google's TPUs, tensor processing units, as opposed to GPUs, graphics processing units, have been around for about 10 years. Google started creating them in 2015 for its own internal purposes, right? Google was running lots and lots of AI and machine learning applications, so they sort of needed this for themselves. But they're very, very, very effective chips. And it's sort of no surprise to me that a company like Google would start to see there being value in selling those chips to other people, particularly because any well-functioning capitalist system, if there's a company making 80, 90% profit margins, as NVIDIA does, you should expect there to be competition to start to lower those margins. And that is what appears to be happening here. We'll see if it works. NVIDIA is a fiercely competitive company, but that's what's happening.
So cheaper, doesn't run as hot, is more productive. Therefore, a lot of folks have been asking whether there will be a real competitor to NVIDIA. Did we finally find one?
Well, I think it could be. I think there's a lot of obstacles that Google faces. The most important one by far is not actually just performance of the chip, it's the software ecosystem. So in a way that's a little bit similar to how the iPhone, you know, Apple's iOS has this huge developer ecosystem, and all these developers, when they make mobile apps, they usually target the iPhone first because it's kind of the premier smartphone market. And, you know, Android being a close second there. There's something similar that happens with NVIDIA chips, where all the developers of machine learning models kind of use NVIDIA's software ecosystem, which is called CUDA. And that's a huge moat that NVIDIA has, possibly more significant even than just their hardware performance. So the question will be, can Google develop a similar type of ecosystem? And it's a big challenge when you consider that Google has been used to using these chips, these TPUs, almost entirely for internal applications and some things that were offered to developers, but this is mostly for them.
Because they were leasing them or renting them at some point for
They do. They rent them on their Google Cloud product, but the idea of selling them to other...
That's all new.
That's new.
So if you're Broadcom, did you just find your new reason to live? I mean, this is, we've seen a huge run up based on a story like this in just over the past couple of days. NVIDIA is one of the only stocks in the tech sector that's lower today. Is this all adding up in your head?
To a certain extent, you know, I mean, the market might be overreacting to this particular piece of news. We'll see, right? I think the idea, Meta is going to be using NVIDIA chips for a long time to come. And and by the way, Google uses NVIDIA chips too.
I was going to say, Google is a client.
Yeah, Google is, I'm sure they're one of NVIDIA's largest customers.
And then I'm supposed to ask you again about circular investing, which do you see as misguided in this case?
Not really in this case, no. I mean, look, again, are there some transactions that happen in this that seem sort of a little fishy?
Yeah.
Maybe, you know, I'm not expert in such things.
Right, sure.
I'm more of a policy
person.
You're
not an accountant.
Yeah, I'm not an accountant. I do have opinions about depreciation schedules, but I'm not an accountant.
Well, those depreciation schedules are a big deal for the investment community right now. And when you look at all these data centers popping up that are going to, you know, pay a lot of money for cooling, they're going to try to harness enormous amounts of energy. Does a TPU or the next generation make all of this unnecessary? Are we going to have data centers on mothballs when the technology catches up?
I don't think so. I think that there's just an enormous amount of underlying demand for AI services. And so, you know, I think the companies that are building these data centers are building them primarily because they have trouble meeting demand right now. You know, OpenAI, Anthropic, these companies are always talking about how limited they are on compute and how they could serve more models, better models, different kinds of products to customers, but they can't because they're compute constrained. So I think they're making a logical calculation. At the end of the day, when it comes to these sort of frontier data centers, you do need to maximize basically computations per square foot. So that becomes very important. But at the same time, Google, on their most recent earnings call, Google talked about how they had very high utilization rates of the NVIDIA V100, V as in Victor, from 7-8 years ago at this point. So that chip is still being used for different kinds of you know, developer purposes. Mm-hmm. So it might not be that you use the frontier chip, you know, for everything. There's a lot of other use cases. And so I think that, you know, the sexiest use cases of AI will probably always be on these, the big training and stuff like that. They'll be on the latest models, but I think there'll be uses. You know, I mean, we'll see. We'll see if that changes. But I tend to think that the depreciation schedules that we see right now are actually, like, reasonable.
Fascinating. And good for us to hit that before you go. We've got about a minute left. Do TPUs accelerate the end game here, where you and I both have a digital twin?
I mean, at the end of the day, competition is inherently accelerationist, right? Yeah. So competition is great in that regard. I hope it makes both NVIDIA and Google better.
Can you sell them to China?
The TPUs? I don't think Google currently does. I think
this could be the next big argument for export controls, huh?
There could be some chips. We'll see if Google wants to.
Right.
But it's very possible. You know, there could be some chips that fall into the sort of export control regulations.
Well, there needs to be a new AI action plan. Do you go back and rewrite that thing at some point?
I don't know about me, but but I think that something like that, you know, a plan like that is worth updating every once in a while.
Fascinating.